Hi, I'm AJ, and thanks for taking the time to check out this video. If you're not a current subscriber, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you're really gonna like this video, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. So a couple of months ago, I made a video called The Power of Compound Interest. Compound interest is known as the eighth wonder of the world because you can use your money to make more money by investing in stocks or other investments. And over time, the initial deposit that you put in, as well as the gains that you get over time, those gains compound on top of each other. That way your money can grow faster. But there is a dark side to compound interest. And that dark side is when you borrow money. So when you borrow money, whether it's for a mortgage or it's for a personal loan, a car loan, or even your credit card, most of those loans have compound interest. So let's say you spend $100 on your credit card. If you don't pay it off at the end of the month, you're then charged an interest rate by the credit card company. Now, most credit card companies and loan providers, they charge a compound interest. So that means that the principal that you borrowed plus any interest that is added onto that principal, that interest can also gain interest. So let's say you spend $100 on your credit card has a 20%, or let's say 24% for easy math, interest rate. So that means every month, you divide that 24% by 12, every month you're being charged 2% for any money that you owe on your credit card that you haven't paid off. So now you haven't paid it off at the end of the month, now you owe $102. If you continue to not pay it, or you just pay whatever the minimum fee is, which could be $5 or $10, then it's going to take you a long time to pay off that debt because you continuously have money that's being added to that debt through compound interest that the credit card or the mortgage provider is charging you. Now, compound interest is very different from simple interest. With simple interest, the only interest you're being charged is on the principal, so the amount that you borrowed. The interest that you're charged for anything that you don't pay off within the month or during the time period that's agreed upon, that money isn't charged additional interest. So make sure with no matter what loan you're taking, check to see whether it's a compound interest rate or if it's a simple interest rate. And the majority of credit cards are all compound interest. And these are how the credit card companies make their money, as well as banks. Whenever a business loans money to you, whether it's a personal loan, mortgage loan, or a credit card, what they're doing is using the money that they have to then make more money off of it. And the thing with banks and credit card companies, especially banks, is that banks, they have money coming in all the time. So when you have your checking account or your savings account, you're actually providing money for the bank to actually allow other people to borrow money. So while you're allowing the bank to hold your money in a savings account, that's why it's so important to try to get an account that's actually giving you a decent return on your savings. While the bank is holding your money, let's say you have $1,000, and if you're getting less than 1% interest rate for your savings, the bank is then using that $1,000 that it's holding for you to allow other people to borrow the money. So if they let someone borrow money for a mortgage that's 3 or 5%, the money that they give you for allowing you to hold the money into their account and use their bank services, they're actually making more money off of it, and they don't have to technically use their own money. And if it's a bank that issues credit cards, that interest rate could be between 14 to 20 and sometimes up to 30% with certain credit cards. And banks don't have to hold on to all of your deposits. So the money that you put in, it's not necessarily saying that the bank is holding that exact amount of cash, actual physical fiat currency in their bank vault. So the bank only has to hold up to 10% of the amount of deposits that they receive. So if a bank receives $1 billion worth of deposits, they only have to hold 100 million. And if they receive less deposits, around 120 million, last time I checked, you can actually hold less than 10% in your reserves as a bank. So if banks only have to hold 10% as reserves that we as their customers deposit into their bank accounts, what does that mean that they're doing with the money? They're using that money, as I mentioned before, to allow other people to borrow. That way they can make money. And they may even be investing that money into the stock market where they can get an average return of 5 to 8% per year. So this is another main reason that I don't hold a lot of money in a general savings account. With the average high yield savings account, you may get a little bit over 2% at the moment. But if you invest that money into the stock market, you can gain anywhere from 5 to 8% on average every year. But an individual year, of course, you could lose money, but you could also even gain up to 20 or 30% just in 1 year when you're investing in the stock market. So maybe we as savers, the amount of money that we have saved, we should only save 10% of it into an actual savings account. The other 90% of our savings, especially once we reach about $1,000 worth of savings that we can hold on to, the rest of that money should go into investing in the stock market or investing in a business. Whatever you feel like investing in, whether it's a business, stocks, or real estate, make sure that 90% of the savings that you have is actually going into something that can gain a higher rate of return. So this was just a quick video to talk about the negative impact of compound interest. Whenever you're borrowing money and they charge a compound interest rate, it means that they can continuously make money as long as you hold a balance, and they can make money off the interest rate that they actually charge you. And not only can they make money off of the principal that you borrowed, but any interest that is gained from you not paying off that principal, they can actually charge interest on that as well. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate you taking this time out of your day. If you're not a current subscriber, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Hit that like button because you really like this video. And also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. So that's all for today. Thanks, you guys have a great day.